Talk.
Hi, and welcome to Talk. Today in the studio we have Kim Fowley and Greg Shaw and Lee Joseph. And we're going to talk to Kim Fowley and his career through the 50s and 60s. He's a rock and roll survivor.
So. Wow.
Kim, so tell us about when you started in high school.
I started at the beginning. 1957, Uni High, Jan and Arnie, Sandy Nelson, Ryan O'Neill, Canned Heat, Frank Sinatra Jr. Kidnappers, and me, all together. Uni High, West L.A.
Did you play in bands then?
Or? No, I was a thief and a polio victim. And I had to do something, so I became the road manager of the Sleepwalkers.
And
who became Kip Tyler and the Flips on Ebb Records.
And then, did they become anything after
yes,
that?
Yes, Bruce Johnson wrote, I write the songs for all those things. He became a Beach Boy. He became Ron Holden's arranger and producer. And Sandy Nelson became Teen Beat. And I became Howard Hughes.
Didn't Randy Newman and Nancy Sinatra go to the
Randy Newman was hiding in the boy's gym in a jester's jacket. And Nancy Sinatra had a biker boyfriend who actually worked in a gas station. And Sandra Dee was in our graduating class, but I got kicked out of high school for living with a 37-year-old woman and selling her liquor to people from Paul Revere Junior High. And they threw me in the Army, and Frank Sinatra sang at our grad night. But everybody made records in high school. We were always going down and trying to get record deals in the junior and senior years.
So did you go on to produce, or what did you do after high
school? I went on to become the music editor of Dig magazine. I predicted the twist in 1959. I lived on the floor of the Red Velvet, which is now the lingerie, and then I became Doris Day's office boy. And I became her publicist. And I worked at American International and produced Charged by the Renegades, Geronimo, Tony Casanova singing Diary of a High School Bride. And the Renegades were in Ghost of Drag Strip Hollow. I dated the studio owner's daughter. That may have had something to do with it. Don't want to hear that story.
No.
Next question. what about you guys? Do you want to ask anything?
Yeah,
I'm more interested in what happened when you left L.A. and went to England.
Yeah.
What was that like?
Like P.J.
Well,
Proby.
We jumped from 59 to 64.
Well.
Let's talk about the hit records I had from 59 to 64. Skip and Flip, Cherry Pie, the
Mermaids.
The Mermaids in 63. I Want to Hold Your Hand knocked us out of number one. Then we had this item here. Do you remember this star? Close up. This had nothing to do with anything, but I thought it was nice to look at.